What is up, everybody? Welcome back to another video. In today's video, we are back with another episode of Lions Latest. And today, we're going to be going through the latest Detroit Lions news, but also some updates on Kerryon Johnson and Hunter Bryant. So let's get it started.
You know, I got a shout out Dosa Dion, man, because it was actually the first time I went live on YouTube. And, you know, guys don't know Dosa Dion. He put out a lot of good content for the Detroit Lions.
And welcome, everybody, to another video. Glad you guys are here. And yes, we got some Detroit Lions news to talk about. How's everybody doing? And today we're going to talk about a couple of updates on Hunter Bryant and Kerryon Johnson, but also someone just got paid. Now, we'll get to that in a second, okay? We'll get to that second. But first, I want to talk about the situation of Hunter Bryant and Kerryon Johnson. So really, in the past week, we've gotten two updates. All right, well, more than that. I mean, Josh Hill retiring, the Detroit Lions signing Darren Fells. But we got two updates. The first one was that Hunter Bryant was released. And then yesterday, we get the reports that Kerryon Johnson was released. But there may be a little bit more to that. And I was trying to figure out what's actually going on here with these two guys, specifically Hunter Bryant, because his whole situation was just confusing the heck out of me. And I think I understand what's happening, okay? So let's start with Hunter Bryant first. So as I mentioned, about a week ago, we were told that Hunter Bryant was released from the Detroit Lions. But then I saw that he was back with the Detroit Lions. And I was like, wait, what's going on? Why is he back with the Detroit Lions already? So let's go through what actually is happening. So from my understanding, here's what's going on with Hunter Bryant. We knew about the non-football injury that he was dealing with. And I don't know what it was. I'm not sure what happened. But we know that there was a non-football injury. So he was injured. It just wasn't football related. Detroit Lions basically released Hunter Bryant, okay? They released Hunter Bryant. Now, since Hunter Bryant has been in the league for less than four seasons, he hits basically the waiver wire. So he can be claimed by all these teams, okay? So his terms can be claimed by a team. But he went through that waiver, and no one claimed Hunter Bryant. So basically what the Detroit Lions did is they basically brought back Hunter Bryant, and they put him on IR, and they agreed to take his terms on for this season. So he's back on injury reserve. Now, we know an injury reserve player, they don't count against the roster, but Bryant's situation is very interesting because he was already placed on the non-football injury reserve list. Now, usually, I guess what happens is they're usually placed on the NFI list, and then if they're not ready by the season, then they're placed on that list. But the Lions already did that. Now, if you're on the injury reserve when the season starts or wherever you are in the season, you have to miss at least six games. I think last year may have been a little bit different because of COVID. But regardless, that means his injury may be pretty darn serious. Again, I don't know what that injury is, that non-football injury, but it may be pretty serious. However, he will not count against the roster because he's on this list, and also his base salary will not count towards the Detroit Lions salary recap, okay? So they're also saving a little bit of money here. But again, I don't know what happened with Hunter Bryant, but it seems like it may be pretty serious. However, he is back with the Detroit Lions. What I've heard is that Hunter Bryant is out for the season. What went down there with Hunter Bryant, okay? I'm not sure what happened to him, but that's obviously not a good thing. But the Detroit Lions, basically, from my understanding, is they waived him. They knew about the injury. No one claimed him. So they said, okay, you know what? Let's just put him back, put him on injury reserve, okay? Because once you waive him, since he's been in the league less than 4 years, he has to go through, you know, waivers. No one claimed him. We're going to put him back on injury reserve. We're going to take on his terms, and he's going to be here for the season. That's what's going on with Hunter Bryant. Kind of a weird situation there, but that's why he's back with the Detroit Lions. I didn't understand that before, and now I kind of do. And then you have the news last night, and this was that Kerryon Johnson was released from the Detroit Lions. The Lions just cut ties with Kerryon Johnson. Now, it could be just as simple as that. And like Hunter Bryant, because he's been in the league for less than four seasons, he's only been for 3 years, he's set to hit waivers. So some team can claim him. But the difference is here, because it wasn't an injury-related thing, if no one claims him, he's just going to become a free agent. And the Lions could sign him back to their practice squad. But then again, any team could sign Kerryon Johnson anywhere he wants to go. So at that point, it's not as, hey, he's coming back, he's going to be on our injury reserve. He can sign with any team if no one claims him. So we'll see what happens then. However, it may be a little bit deeper than that. Kerryon Johnson may not have actually just been released. Those were the reports that everybody was just throwing out there, even including myself, because that's what I saw. However, I've heard that Brad Holmes maybe hasn't made that final decision yet, as he said is a work in progress. All right. Now, people are speculating that basically that could mean the Detroit Lions may actually be trying to trade Kerryon Johnson. We know that these little rumors can get out there. Not even rumors. These little reports can get out there from the, you know, whoever it is, whoever's working with Kerryon, his agent, whatever it may be. And then all of a sudden it's just flying all over. And that's what we hear. The Detroit Lions may not have actually released him officially yet. The thought is that they actually may be looking for a trade partner. Now, unfortunately, when you have it out there that he's released, it's maybe more difficult to find a trade partner. But the idea is the Lions may be looking for a trade for Kerryon Johnson to try to land any pick. Now, I've heard of two teams potentially being interested. Those include the Miami Dolphins, who may have wanted him back when he was drafted, and the New York Giants, who would like to have some depth behind Saquon Barkley. I've heard those two teams. I'm not completely sure, though. So the Detroit Lions may, before they actually release him, they may try to trade him away and try to land some kind of pick. Okay, he was a second round pick. That means his contract's not, you know, that expensive for a rookie. And like I said, he did have a lot of talent. We know like the kind of talent that he was. So I would assume that if he was, you know, just out there on waivers, that he would get claimed by somebody. However, the Detroit Lions may be like, hey, not so fast. We're actually going to try to trade Kerryon Johnson, see if we can get anything in return for the final year of his deal, even if that's a seventh round pick, regardless, instead of just letting him go. So the reports out there was that he was released, but it may not be like that yet. However, it could be. You know, you could watch this video and at that time it may be official he has been released, but what I've heard is it, you know, may not actually be all the way in yet, because Brad Holmes said it's still a work in progress. So we'll see what happens there with Kerryon. But as I mentioned, if the Detroit Lions, they do waive him, he's going to hit waivers, someone can claim him. If they don't, then the Lions could obviously bring him back if they wanted to, but then he's a free agent. He could go sign with any team that he wants to. He just has to hit the waivers first because he's been in the league for less than four seasons, all right? So that's kind of the breakdown of how that works. I'm sorry, I know I probably messed it up. We have the news, and this is that Frank Ragnow has gotten an extension for the Detroit Lions to be the highest paid center as of right now in the NFL. Let's give it up for Frank Ragnow. Congrats, Frank! Frank's looking at a four-year, $54 million extension after 2022 when his fifth-year option, you know, is done, which is basically $13.5 million a season. Now, that's even more than his fifth-year option, which is $12.5 million for 2022. You're making money, Frank! Hey, what are you doing? You want to send me a gift card or something? No. Frank, I see you though. Hey, you do your thing, man. So Frank Ragnow just got paid, and every year he has been improving. We know we drafted him back in 2018 in the first round. The Detroit Lions decided to exercise his fifth year option. So now, as of right this second, he is the highest paid center in the league after this extension. And he is locked up all the way through 2026. All right, now the guy is only 24 years old. All right, so he's going to be here through 2026 if we want to keep him around. That is absolutely crazy, but I think it's very well deserving. And we've seen this, you know, guys reset the market. They do things like that. Before him, it was Corey Linsley, who was the highest paid center. He went to the Chargers, and now Frank Ragnow being due for that extension, the Detroit Lions made it happen. And Brad Holmes said himself that when he was hired, you know, when he came here, he said Frank Ragnow reached out to him and he said, hey, you play the game the right way. We're not going to wait with this. PFF ranked him as the third best center last season. But if you look, year by year, he's improved. He went from guard to center, and that was a huge jump. But every year, he's been better and better. And we may have to do some film on Frank Ragnow, just because, why not? I mean, I've watched some film on him, and it's impressive. It really is. I mean, the pass protection and zero sacks, it almost doesn't do justice when you watch him. The guy can just pick up stunts. He can stick with those interior pass rushers. I mean, he has no issue with those guys whatsoever. He's a run blocker. Great run blocker as well when he's able to get connected with some of those defensive linemen. The only issue is he's not great at the second level, but he's also a center, so I guess it's understandable. He's obviously very deserving, but we may just do a film video on him. Kind of want to. All right, we have to do something on my man getting the extension and why maybe he was worth it, or maybe he wasn't worth it. I'm not sure. I'm pretty sure he was worth it, though. Frank Ragnow has also been extremely reliable. He's only missed three games in the three seasons that he's been in the league, and last season, two of them came with the, you know, fractured throat cartilage, so he couldn't talk, but he still finished the game. He was dealing with that injury, so, you know, the guy's gonna play. He is kind of the leader. He's like the quarterback of the offensive line playing the center position, and that's awesome. And also, we know he can give you some versatility as well. He can play the guard position because that's what he started at with the Detroit Lions when he moved there once he came into Detroit. But the great thing about this is, holistically, is that the offensive line, in theory, is set. It's set. All right, if you look at our projected starters for next season, the Detroit Lions have everybody locked up for at least the next three seasons. This Taylor Decker is locked up through 2024. Now, he does have an out after 2022 if the Lions wanted to go that direction. His cap is really going to start to pick up as it's $18.9 million, $17.8 million, $17.6 million. He's getting paid a lot, but he is the left tackle, so it makes sense. Those guys do get paid a lot. Then at left guard, you have Jonah Jackson. He's still on his rookie deal. He started last season, assuming he starts again this next season at left guard. His contract is through 2023. Frank Ragnow now is through 2026. Big V, let's just start with Big V for a second. Big V's contracted through 2024, but he has an out after this year. So the Lions could easily exercise that out if they wanted to. I could see that happening if he doesn't take a huge jump that season, because when you consider how much we're actually paying him. However, then even behind him at Logan Stenberg, drafted the same year as Jonah Jackson, he's also through 2023. So both these guys, you know, maybe they become starters if the Lions move on Big V. They're still locked up to it through at least 2023. And then at the right tackle position. Let's just say hypothetically it's Penei Sewell that takes that position. Obviously he's on his rookie deal. He's locked up through 2024 and he has the fifth year option because he was a first round pick. So all these guys are locked up. Now behind that, Terrell Crosby, we know that Terrell Crosby, you know, he's on the last year of his deal. Like I said, Big V does have an out, but technically if he didn't, you know, use that out, he could be locked up through 2024. So the really, you got six offensive linemen that are locked up through at least 2023. So really, I mean, in theory, this offensive line is set for the next three seasons, which is just awesome to hear that. It's like, what? Our offensive line could be set for the next 3 years? I'm talking a good offensive line, not just like, oh, we have offensive linemen. Like, good offensive linemen all locked up, all right? This was a goal of Bob Quinn when he came in here. He did some of it, and now the Lions look like they may have completed it. So this is really awesome. I mean, just thinking about the fact that that's what our offensive line is looking like is pretty darn awesome. Of course, behind that, you know, depth, it's not as long. You know, those guys are locked up, but that's because they're kind of like one-year deals. They're in and out, you know, they're UDFAs, things like that. But like I said, for the most part, you got guys locked up. You still have Terrell Crosby, but he's on a final year of his deal. I don't know if the Lions will extend him or not, but now after Penei Sewell, it may not happen. We heard Brad Holmes say after they drafted Penei Sewell that now tackle isn't going to be a need next season. So we will see, but regardless, it's pretty darn awesome that that's what our offensive line looked like. Frank Ragnow specifically allowed zero sacks last season. Grayed out was the third best center in the league and only had three penalties. So fantastic stuff there. Like I said, he's been durable as well. And yes, the Lions offensive line is looking good. So little update on Kerryon and Hunter Bryant. And also, Frank Ragnow got paid, baby. Congratulations, Frank Ragnow. You do your thing. Let me know your thoughts, comments below. I'll keep you guys updated on the Kerryon and Hunter Bryant situations. And I'm out.